Hi friends, welcome to WSOTA with Cup of Coffee. I am Prabhakaran Thottur Sembiyan. So today we are going to start the APA Manager series, and in the first video of APA Manager series, today we are going to discuss about the components, architecture and the features of WSOTA APA Manager. Let's get into the video.
What is APA Manager? APA Manager is used to design, publish, manage the lifecycle and secure the APIs. APA Manager is not the place where you do the actual development of your APIs. Rather, you develop your APIs in some other place like EI, for an example, or some other programming language, and expose those APIs through APA Manager as a proxy. The APIs published through APA Manager are secured through different security mechanisms, and you can manage the lifecycle of the APIs in the APA Manager. And you can publish, deprecate, block, or change the lifecycle of the API using API Manager. So the API Manager architecture is that it has different planes. First one is a tooling, management plane, data plane, and control plane. Tooling is the place where we actually develop the APIs or design the APIs rather in the Eclipse-based integration studio. Next one is a management plane. Management plane is the place where you design your API or you publish your API or you subscribe to your API. Actually, data plane is the place where the published API from the publisher will reside on. So data plane has something called as gateway. Is nothing but a runtime where your actual API resides. So when you call the API that are published through publisher, the API call will directly come to the gateway, and you can have different types of gateway like internal gateway and external gateway, which we'll discuss later. Next, we have control plane. Control plane has a traffic manager, key manager, and other AI capabilities. We will discuss them later. So coming to management plane, has two different web portals. One is a publisher, another one is a developer portal. Publisher is a place where you design your API, like you define the API name, you define the endpoint the API has to call, you define the context, you define the multiple resources, you define what are all the subscription policies available for an API. Developer portal is like an app store where all the APIs that are published in the publisher are available for subscription. Thing is that unless you subscribe to an API through developer portal, you cannot access an API. And to subscribe an API, you need an account from a developer portal application, which ideally is an user account in API Manager. So this way we are securing that no one can access the API without a proper credential. In the data plane, it has gateways. Like there can be a possibility of more than one gateway, like internal and external gateway. The need of internal and external gateway in the current applications are that there are situations where you can have two different APIs. One can be accessed by the public network, whereas the other API can be accessed only from people inside the network. So to achieve this, you can have more than one gateway. One is for public, another one is for internal. That way you can have two gateways. One is external and another one is an internal gateway. As discussed in the architecture, gateway is essentially a runtime of your API Manager. So all the APIs that are published through publisher resides in the gateway. And the gateway is the medium through which any requests that are coming to your API Manager will first hit the gateway. Then gateway enforces the key validation, security limitation, or rate limiting policies. Before going to control plane, let us talk about the security mechanism offered by API Manager. So when you publish your API through publisher portal, you can define what type of authentication mechanism or what type of security mechanism you want to enforce for a particular API. You can enforce OAuth 2, you can enforce basic auth, or you can enforce API key. So if you don't want any security mechanism for your API, you cannot describe that globally. Rather, you can choose a particular resource and you can define whether you want authentication mechanism or not for a particular resource of a respective API. So we have seen gateway enforces the security validations and rate limiting validation. Then the control comes to the control plane where actual validations takes place. So the key manager is responsible for validating the security aspects. Like if your API request has OAuth 2 based tokens, be it opaque or JWT or an API key or basic authentication, what key manager does is that it extracts that value and it validates them against the value stored in the database. If the validation fails, the key manager sends a response back to gateway saying that this API validation, security validation has failed, and the gateway rejects that message back to the caller saying that security, invalid credentials has been provided. Next, what does a traffic manager do? Traffic manager takes care of the rate limiting policies or throttling policies. Let's say I have published an API for a tier called Gold, where that only 100 requests per minute can be accessed by a particular user. But what I am doing is, like, I have exited the 100 request. I am initiating the 101th request. So what does traffic manager do is, like, it will check whether the quota has been exceeded or not. So this is just an example. So it will check whether the quota has been exceeded or not. If it has been exceeded, it sends a message to the gateway saying that the quota has been exceeded, and the gateway rejects the message back to the caller saying the quota has been exceeded. Only if the key manager and traffic manager validations are successful, the message will be processed to your backend API. If not, the message will be rejected by the gateway after validating the incoming rate limiting policies and the security aspects from key manager and traffic manager. So this way, we are securing our backend applications highly. Today, we have seen about the components, architecture, and the features of API Manager. In the next video, we will try to set up, configure, and run the API Manager in our laptop or desktop.
Please do provide your valuable suggestions and feedback in the comment box, and also share this video with someone who will be interested to learn WSO2. Thanks everyone. Please take care of yourselves in this current COVID-19 pandemic situation. We will meet in the next videos or the upcoming videos. Until then, it's Prabhakaran Thodithotsembiyan signing off. Bye.